enough.
All right, beautiful. Here we are. We've got Starplayer TVs from Duesenberg.
We do.
Two of them. Two crazy Starplayer TVs. You got the Outlaw?
I do. My Outlaw.
Yep. And this one is just a standard?
That is the Catalina Avalon Blue. Don't quote me on it.
Sounds good.
Sounds good.
Cool. Yeah, these things are awesome. You know, obviously they're sort of like a hollow Les Paul in a lot of ways, but also totally different.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Duesenberg's been a huge part of our company for probably 5-6 years now.
Yeah.
It's like kind of one of the key unique brands that we've kind of kept.
Yep.
And the Starplayer is the model.
It's their Strat, isn't it? It's like...
Well, actually, they do the Coleman now, but... Oh, sorry.
But I mean,
yes, you're right.
They're known for.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah, so Duesenberg's a German company.
Yes.
But we're just discussing this because there's...
That big elephant sitting over there?
Yeah, sitting in the room. So these are actually mostly made by... in the Mer factory, which is in Korea.
Mm.
And they make... Revolta guitars.
The other brand that we do, Revolta.
Yeah. So there are some similarities in feel to Revolta guitars. But having said that, lots of people out there feel a bit funny about guitars that are made in Asia.
Yeah.
Because of old stereotypes that don't really exist anymore. But these are like super high-end... Incredibly well-made guitars.
Yeah, Japan and Korea these days are pretty highly regarded.
Totally.
And anyone who actually owns or plays a doozy would swear by it. Would swear by it because they are amazingly made guitars.
Yeah.
So I mean, they are. I don't know what percentage of it comes. I don't think the entire guitar is made there or comes out of that factory.
Yeah.
I think maybe the hardware's put in Germany, perhaps.
Yeah.
There's not really a lot of information.
Yeah, it's hard to tell. Yeah. But they get it to a point and then they send it to Germany.
Yeah.
And Germany puts it through the Plek process.
Yeah.
Which makes the whole thing incredibly playable, like super low action. It's probably one of the more comfortable guitars to play that we sell anyway.
Yeah. Yeah. 100%. I mean, they're pretty perfect, you know, as you'd almost expect from... either a German guitar or a Japanese or a really high-end Korean, you know.
Yeah.
Finishes are amazing. Setups are always really good because then to be honest, we don't need to set them up when we get them in the shop. You know, unless they sit around for a bit or we change the gauge of strings or anything like that. But
the guitars are amazing. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, yours has come straight out of the...
Yeah.
Straight out of the case. And
feels like $1 million, super easy to play.
Mm.
Really like kind of fast feeling action on it.
Mm.
The necks are perfectly set up. It's intonated well. You can bomb these trims. We'll talk about that later.
But why don't we get through the specs?
Yeah, let's do that. So yeah, as you can see, these are a semi-hollow construction. There's a center block that runs down the middle of them. But one thing that makes these a little bit different from other guitars that are made in a similar way is these are actually a spruce top instrument with a maple back, maple neck, and Indian rosewood fretboard.
And generally a bit of flame maple on the back as well.
So, yeah.
I mean, kind of, they can be super pretty.
This one's got my fingerprints all over it.
Mine's got scratches.
Yeah. so they resonate really well acoustically. I don't know if you can hear it through the room mic, but... So, making them really nice to play at home, unplugged. So, do you want to talk about the electronics in it?
Sure. Yeah. So, Duesenberg's most popular pickup setup is these two. So, this is the Grand Vintage Humbucker.
Mm.
And in the bridge, and then the Domino P90 in the neck. So, that's it, like, in a couple of models. You get it in the Caribous and other ones. Gives you a great... all-round tone, so...
Yeah, it's a really, like, creamy sound from that P90-style pickup in the neck, but this humbucker is, like, I don't know, I had one of these for a long time and I was playing on stage, and one thing that's amazing about that pickup is how it cleans up.
Mm.
It seems to get, like, brighter as you clean up, and you can get some really cool, clean, kind of jangly sounds out of it.
Yeah, should we get through this, yeah?
Yeah, demonstrate.
You can put it on to you.
Yep. So, this is... with the humbucker all the way up. pick all the way, well, pretty much all the way down. It doesn't really lose that much top end, you know, in the middle position.
P90 is dreamy. Do you want the delay on?
Do you want to go through yours? I'm just going to steal this for a second.
Yep.
Yours is exactly the same makeup as well, isn't it? It's the same pickup.
Nothing different. All right, so just checking out some of the gain tones that this thing can do. So we're on the bridge, and we'll start with just a clean. So full volume. Not quite so bright. Not quite so bright and clear on the neck pick on that one. Yeah, but yeah.
So that's probably my favorite part about these guitars is the way that they, especially that humbucker, cleans up when you roll out.
Yep.
These are an interesting kind of guitar straight out of the box. They come with 10 to 50 gauge strings on them.
I think that's correct. I think that's all about the trim. So the 10 to 50, which strangely doesn't feel heavy.
No, it feels kind of normal.
Yeah.
It's a 25.5 inch scale length as well. So it's a really like kind of snappy guitar to play. Like it feels, I don't know, you can bash it and it stays in tune pretty well.
With the trim,
yeah, it's super cool for like having that much kind of it's not extra tension really, but it just feels super stable. So for like stuff like palm muting and like just feels really tight, you know, and articulate.
Yeah.
That's cool. And I guess probably, like, you know, the other world that you could delve into where that would be good as well is kind of bluesy jazz kind of lead lines. Yeah. Just feels like, you know, really instant, the sound out of it. This is the Diamond Deluxe Tremola that they do. I reckon this is probably the best trem in the world, in my opinion. It just returns really, really well. It looks like a Bigsby. it plays nothing like a Bigsby.
Yeah, and the main thing about it is its subtleness.
Yeah.
So, like, when you're clean, and so when you're, like, you can kind of get...
If you went that far on a Bigsby, it'd be game over.
Yeah. 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 Because, well, I mean, they're just not designed to do that much, right?
Yeah.
You want to talk about, like, because that's got a lot of pivot points on it as well.
Yeah. So, I kind of, when I'm trying to explain these tremps to people in the shop, you know, to me, it feels most like a Jazzmaster or a Jaguar trem system. Mm. You know, like, Bigsby's are very much kind of like, what would you call that? Like, kind of square in their uh-huh. movements.
Yeah.
But this, as you play, you can do, like, big, windy, kind of Jeff Beck-esque kind of playing and, like, just add, like, subtle little bits of modulation into you. Like, mess with people's heads a bit.
Yeah. Yeah, but you're right. I mean, it's not as up and down as a Bigsby.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and one thing that I would always find with my one was, like, if I was on stage and, like, maybe there's, like, you know, a pause in the song and you're working with your feedback, you can kind of, like, wrangle your feedback really well with this.
Right.
So it'll start, like, feeding back, you know, in a particular frequency, and then you can kind of bend out of that frequency and into others.
Right.
With this, which I don't know, like,
for guys who've got to fill, who need a gig in between dudes playing a song, they just get up on stage and that could be a thing.
Exactly. Or if you're like a noise musician.
Well, you know, you don't want to be the guy who's always doing that thing where you wind the delay out to 10 minutes.
Totally. Or, like, say it's just like, you know, one long held note while the bass player is playing underneath.
Mm.
You can kind of do some interesting kind of modulating, like, over the top of that with, like, a reverb and a delay as well. You know, some people are worried about playing instruments with hollow aspects to them because of the feedback issues, but this really kind of allows feedback to be part of the instrument rather than, like, it's not out of control at all. It's there when you want it to be there, which I think is really cool, you know, like, and that's kind of maybe unique to this. Like, you start playing with, like, a 335 and it's a little bit more out of control. 330, really out of control.
Yeah.
Strat, kind of not really there enough,
yep.
you know, yep. For it to be used in that way.
This is really, I mean, you can point this thing really easily.
Yeah.
Yep.
So it's cool. It's really cool. Everything on it is Duesenberg. They don't use any, like, third-party parts, do they?
No. I mean, you know, look, you know, they don't.
Except for that fake leather.
Oh, come on, man. that's a real crocodile, I'm sure.
Yeah. What was the company called? Whatever. I've already forgotten what they were called. Anyway, there's a fake leather company that makes that.
Yeah.
But they do their own machine heads, and they're fantastic.
Let's be honest. I mean, like, part of the thing about Duesenbergs is they're just really stylish.
Yeah,
I mean, maybe stylish. Not. You know, most people may not like my faux leather guitar, but you know, that is a classy looking guitar.
Yeah, it's got, like, the art deco kind of stylings to it, which, yeah, a lot of people love. Yeah, and then, you know, lots of familiar aspects at the same time. So one thing that should be brought up that maybe isn't spoken about in a lot of the videos is they come with a ridiculously good hard case.
Oh, yeah.
They're
living in that one for the past. That's how good it is.
Yeah. Yeah. They're, like, really, really rigid.
Times are tough.
I've flown with mine a lot and, like, never had any problems. They're just kind of, like, probably one of the best cases that come with a guitar out of our shop, I reckon.
Yeah.
This edging is, like, really, really rigid. So you chuck it down a conveyor belt in an airport and it's going to be totally fine. The trem, you just put it back and then stick it in there.
Yeah. But I mean, that thing is super solid.
Yeah.
Like, super solid.
Yeah. Way more than other cases that come through. Yeah. Yeah. So that's cool. Plus, you're kind of less likely to have another guitar like that on your flight, so you know that it's yours really quickly.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, so that's the Starplayer. Let's get some more sounds out of it, and then roll credits.
All right, I reckon you're on, so I'm on. Go for it.
Okay, cool.